In this video, let's go over e-commerce custom reports that you can use. And in particular, we're going to use Justin's daily e-commerce traffic report. So we'll go ahead and import it by clicking on this link. And once it's imported, it'll bring it in and it looks something along the lines of this. The very first thing we're going to do, of course, is take a look at behind the scenes to see how this report was built. So we see the title of the report here. We see the type of report. So in this case, an Explorer report. Then there's the metrics. So these are our numbers, number of sessions, again, the visits coming to the site. We've got the number of those, the percentage in those that are new. We've got our bounce rate, pages per session. So these are really good engagement metrics to kind of give us an idea of how people are actually interacting with our site and the behaviors that are happening. Then we've got more results-oriented metrics like revenue, average order value, and per session value. So the amount of money we're making per session or per visit in Google Analytics. And then it's sorted, in this case, by dimensions of source medium, that is the brand of traffic that's sending us the traffic, and then the medium, which is the type of traffic. And then when we click onto that, it'll drill down and break it down by campaign. So we can see the actual specific campaigns that are sending us those results. We're going to click on save and take a look at what this report shows us here. So as we scroll down, we've got our source mediums. And we're going to start with Google CPC. Let's just start here. So we'll do Google CPC. This is our Google Ads traffic coming in. And we can see the number of sessions. So 738, about 5% of our users, 4.3% of our users coming in here. About a little more than half, in this case, are new, which means there's a probably, you know, it's a pretty good amount of returning. So about 48% returning, 38% returning. So that's pretty decent. Then we've got a bounce rate that shows us 38%. Now, in and of itself, does this mean anything? Not really. But what it means is when you start comparing it, it starts getting context. When you give things context, that's when you can start figuring out the patterns and the trends. So in this case, this one is a much better bounce rate than this one. So this is a higher bounce rate. So we've got our DFA traffic coming in here. So that's bringing in a much higher bounce rate. So they're not as engaged. But these other sites that are referring traffic definitely have a lower bounce rate. So these are a little bit more engaged, but overall not doing too bad. Pages per session, same concepts here, right? You can see some of these other traffic sources have quite a bit more pages per session. So 6 pages, 8 pages. This one's almost 5. These other ones quite a bit lower. So you see they're not really interacting as much. The behaviors aren't as engaged with from these particular traffic sources. And then we take a look at the results. That's what it matters. We're spending money on Google Ads. So we've got Google CPC, all this traffic, the type of behaviors that they're engaging with our site. And then we've got the revenue. So what are the actual results here? So in this case, we've got $300, a little bit more than that coming through in revenue, which brings us an average order of 25. And then per session, it means we're making about 45 cents from this particular traffic source. Not too bad. Not as good as this other one where we're making almost $7, but this is a referral site, right? So this is another type of traffic source. So traffic sources, comparatively, this particular traffic source, our Google CPC traffic source, it's great. It's making us some money, but it's not anywhere near as good as this particular traffic source, right? You can tell that just by the numbers when you compare the two together. That said, let's drive further down to see if we can improve the efficiency of this Google CPC campaign or Google Ads campaign. So as we scroll down, we see it's now listed by campaign. This is because the custom report was built to show us the campaign. So I can see this YouTube brand. So this is the Google Ads campaign for the YouTube brand. We've got the number of sessions coming in. So it's about a third of all of our traffic coming in. And you can see it doesn't really result in a lot of revenue. So our per session, we're only making 9 cents. But if you look at Office, the campaign for office equipment, right, still sends a decent amount of traffic, right? Not as much, but a decent amount. And we see our engagement metrics are actually quite a bit better. So YouTube, 63% bounce rate, but this one's only 18%. So again, don't get caught up in the numbers themselves, but look at the pattern here. The bounce rate, there's definitely a lot less people that are bouncing. And you can also see here that in the pages per session, where they've got almost 7 pages per session. This one barely hits the 2, right? Then you look at the results. Revenue, you can see that in the revenue results. You got $123 sold here, average order volumes higher on this other traffic source, and our per session value is 72 cents compared to barely a dime. So automatically with this report, you can start to understand how you can improve your own e-commerce performance based on analyzing the traffic coming in. Let me know how you are actually using what you've learned in this video to improve your own marketing efforts. And also, of course, if you like topics like this, be sure to like this video and also subscribe to the CXL channel. That way you'll be notified whenever a new video is available.